Hi, my name is Margarita Morozova, and I teach foreign language education course at Kazakh Blaikan University of International Relations and World Languages. I teach my course with the help of the book Internet-Based Teacher Training Guide. And today I offer you to listen to the way cognitive visualization works in this book. So we see lots of visual aids, lots of pictures. And today I'm going to explain you how can teachers use cognitive visualization to stimulate learners' professional, critical, and creative thinking. So I offer you to look at the pictures that you see on the slide, and you see that all these pictures were used as a base to model image-based thinking stimulating case. So as you see, it works as a communicative incentive to stimulate professional communication and thinking. And we all know that students are different in the way they perceive things. So mainly it depends on their personal and academic background, their psychological characteristics, and their professional motivation. And what I offer teachers to do is to use visualized fragments to stimulate learners' expressiveness in developing their professional identity. So mainly they're free to interpret visualized fragments, which actually helps them to freely express their professional inclinations, professional talents, and reveal their hidden professional identity. In my context, in teacher training, in teacher training course. So, what I offer you to pay attention to today is how can teacher model image-based thinking stimulating fragment to stimulate learners' teacher training thinking. And the quality of this kind of case equally depends on the quality of an image you pick and the quality of a task you equip it with. So today I offer you to see the way this kind of cases that I present in my book we may model. So could you please pay attention to the slide where we have two main pictures that are going to serve as a good example of teacher training case, of image for teacher training case. So once you see two kind of pictures, you may actually notice that one of the pictures lack the text. So if you see on the drum, we may see the word test, whereas the second picture has this word removed. And what I offer you to think about is how can we use this kind of a visual fragment to stimulate our learners' professional thinking. If you pay attention, the second picture widens and broadens students' professional thinking, because if they need to think about the first picture, it is obvious that they need to think about the test, whereas the second picture lacks this notion and their interpretation may be absolutely different. So they may think about different things and they may actually interpret the second picture differently. So it doesn't depend on the word test. And if you pay attention to the next slide, you may see that I offer you to think about two levels of difficulties. So the first level of difficulty pursues as the ultimate aim the interpretation of elements in the picture. So as you see, point three, think about five professional problems that may be revealed, that may be elicited from the picture. And as you see, it goes as ultimate aim. Interpretation goes as ultimate aim. Actually, it is good for to begin your lesson or to start brainstorming some more ideas. But what I'm more interested in is the level, the second level of interpretability, where the process of interpretation goes just a transfer between interpretation of an image and doing the final task. So as you may see in the slide, final task is going to be to work out to offer a teaching training booklet or brochure for a seminar, but it is already assumed that they need to interpret the picture. Actually, if you see, I'm sorry, I returned to previous slide. If you see that the beauty in the case, in the second level difficulty case, is the following. Whatever they interpret, and no matter how they interpret the picture, the task of the case is actual under any kind of interpretation. Whatever they choose. No matter if they choose to interpret it like disruptive students, ruin the discipline, or stressful environment in teaching, the task is already and always actual under any kind of interpretation. Actually, that's what I'm speaking about. It reveals and it helps my students to express their professional identity and never limits their thinking. Okay, and right now I want you to pay attention to the process of modeling image-based thinking-stimulating fiction cases. So, and what I want you to pay attention to right now is the criteria of picking up good pictures to model a quality image-based thinking-stimulating element. So, what I want you to pay attention to is four criteria. You may widen this criteria using your experience or research in the process of modeling. And still, what I offer you to observe as a main one is diversity of elements or their non-standard combination in the picture. So as you see, this picture with the lion, it contains a number of elements like teacher, whip, drum, students, lion, and so on. So typically you can never meet the combination of these elements in reality, which is actually good because it somehow stimulates learners to think about the interaction between elements. So the second criterion I offer you to think about is interpretability of elements. So you may test it by yourself, so please think about the level of interpretability. If you see that the elements interacting in the picture, they may be interpreted differently depending on your student's perception, it is actually good. For example, if we speak about drum, why do we have drum in the picture like this? So maybe it is the instrument of maintaining discipline, or maybe it is the instrument of entertaining your learners. So if you see that your elements possess high level of interpretability, this is good picture. So the problem may be presented explicitly or implicitly. Still, what I actually practice with my students is offering them to work out to elicit the problem, problem statement, statement themselves. So, and the desirable criterion is illustration of a scene. So it should look, this picture with the lion looks like a screenshot from the movie, and it is actually good because your students may be offered an opportunity to think about what happened before it or what will happen next. So this is the desirable fourth component, fourth criterion. So actually, your final question is, does my picture fit this criteria? So you may use this kind of question to self-regulate. Okay, so right now I want you to pay attention to the pictures that I used for this book to model image-based thinking-stimulating fragment. And as you see, only two first pictures, with a lion and with a Snow White, they fit four criteria, whereas others fit only three criteria. Still, these are good thinking-stimulating image elements. So I also use, for my book, I also use different kind of comics, different kind of cartoons, bubble diagrams, different kind of schemes, infographics, and covers of the books, both electronic and paper-based, to stimulate my learners' compensatory and anticipatory skills in what we call guessing or predicting what kind of a content does it have inside, or to extract as many content elements as they only can. So the question number two is, what kind of a professional thinking can I stimulate in my learners? So actually, professional thinking can be different. And what I offer you to think about right now is five types of professional thinking that I consider necessary to stimulate and to develop through this kind of image-based thinking stimulating elements. So these are analytic and critical thinking, conceptual and inventive thinking, and reflective thinking goes as separate. So as a base, I offer you to pay attention to the slide. So you see this is comics cartoon, which is called Perfect Teacher. In this case, you see the famous cartoon hero. But in my case, I offered it my students to start thinking about what a teacher's competence set is necessary for them as future teachers. And each competence corresponds to each pictorial element, which is indicated with the help of an arrow. Okay, so what I want you to think about is the basic task that equip this picture, that serve as a base for this picture, that stimulates your learner's professional analytic thinking. It actually, it is, as I just told you, discuss which teacher's competence symbolizes, are symbolized by this pictorial elements. So you see, it looks like fun, and at the same time, they start interpreting elements. And I didn't have students that had identical actually interpretation, because they all work differently and their cognition also work differently. So if you want to stimulate your learners' professional critical thinking, you may ask them to think what kind of elements can they add, omit, or change to improve the illustration of teacher's necessary competence set. If you want to stimulate your learner's conceptual thinking, which actually goes in the context of teacher training, you may offer them to think what kind of pedagogical notions should they be aware of to guess, and to guess correctly, the meaning of pictorial elements that picture actually competences. If you want to stimulate your learners' inventive thinking, you may think about how can they add two more components to a pictorial element that pictures the competence to make it more expressive, to make it more explicit in its depiction. And finally, to stimulate my learners in reflection, I can give them a task like this. Discuss which teacher's competences are most difficult to develop and to support during your teaching practice. So I also want to state, to point out that in the in conditions of Kazakhstan and other countries that use the teach subject, the teach discipline with the help of non-native language of instruction like English, it is important and it is necessary to preserve this communicative function of the tasks, which actually are very important to support their present level of communicative competence. So what I also want you to pay attention to as a summary of this kind of comment is, can I combine two thinking operations, two thinking challenges in one task? And of course, yes, you may do it. So you may simultaneously form two or three types of of thinking types, for example, analytic and inventive, or conceptual and reflective. And if you pay attention to the slide, you may see that in this case, we develop students' analytic and inventive types of thinking, because students need to think about the meaning of the picture, and after that they need to invent the title for the conference that goes under the emblem like this, Snow White with a apple, electronic apple. So this kind of a case illustrates conceptual and reflective thinking of my learners, because firstly you see the bubble picture, that you see the bubble diagram, and they need to interpret the pedagogical notions that they see, and after that they need to come up with their own reflection if these kind of competences are difficult to develop, and if they are difficult, why. And or this kind of a toolbox, UC Comprehension Toolkit. It also works best for analytic and inventive competence, because they need to think what kind of a pack of objects, pedagogical objects, does this box contain, and after that to think about what kind of objects can we add to make it even more pedagogically valuable. And others. And the last question that I want you to pay attention to is, can I, as a teacher, offer them pictorial material to work out the task for each other themselves? And of course, this is very important to offer to your learners. You may just offer the pictures like that, so you may pay attention to the slide, where they just have the picture, and their task as a students of teacher training faculty is work out the pedagogically, methodologically valuable task themselves. In this case, I offer you to organize it like brainstorming, and after that, when in pairs they work out the necessary task equipping the picture, they can exchange and think about the estimation, the reflection of showing each other the quality of task and showing each other the ways of improvement the task. And only after that, they may exchange to start working upon the challenge that they worked out for each other. And what I want you to pay attention to is the mail. I would like you to reflect. I would be happy get your reflection on the ideas that I expressed. And you may post those ideas to my mail. And I remind you that this was the presentation about how a teacher can model an image-based thinking-stimulating case, in my case, for students of teacher training faculty. Thanks for your attention.